The Justice Brown Blueford Coalition would like to welcome all the Bay Area friends and family who are here to march with us.
Justice for Ellen!
No justice, no peace!
No justice, no peace!
Jose Gonzalez, Anita Gay, Oscar Grant, and many, many others. In a country where the police kill, on average, 364 people per year, nearly one a day, and where 35% of those people are black, when the cops shoot a young black man, it cannot be treated as an accident. It cannot be understood as a mistake. It is not even a crime in the ordinary sense. When the cops kill people of color, that is simply the normal operation of a racist institution in a grossly unequal society. That's the job that the police are put there to do. That role goes all the way back to the origin of the police institution. The modern US police are the descendants of an older body called the slave patrols. Those patrols were militia organizations responsible for keeping slaves on the plantation and, more importantly, responding to or preventing slave revolts. As the country industrialized and urbanized, the slave patrols evolved and took on the characteristics of what we now recognize as a modern police force. And tellingly, their mission expanded, not only the control of slaves, but free blacks and poor whites as well. In the 200 years since that time, the form of inequality has changed. From slavery to segregation to legal equality masking social inequality. But the role of the police has remained remarkably constant. The police developed to control poor people and people of color, and they are still on that job today. That suggests very strongly that the racism and violence of the police are not incidental, but are inherent features of the institution. And that means, among other things, that we cannot reform our way out of our police problem. The 20th century was the century of reform. We saw police campaigns against municipal corruption, mid-century efforts to professionalize the police force, and then introduction of military discipline, the emergence of community policing, diversity training, and the creation of advisory boards. As a result, the police today are better trained, better paid, better organized, better armed than any other point in history. And they continue to act as racist thugs.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Yeah.
The core function of preserving inequality remains very much the same. Our efforts then should not be directed toward fixing this institution, but toward destroying it.
Yeah!
Ultimate goal must always be kept in mind. We should pursue changes that delegitimize, demoralize, discredit, and disempower the police.
Yes.
And which correspondingly energize, embolden, and empower the community. When we demand justice, let us be clear that it is not the justice of the courts and the government, but the justice that abolishes courts and government that is required.
Yes.
Our very demands should be a form of attack.
officer that shot an 18-year-old young man that was not armed, that was not a threat to him, while he was lying on his back on the ground, should be prosecuted for that, because that is called murder. Yeah. And that's why we are all here. Because a police officer murdered a young man. You have multiple tens of witnesses that said he was lying on his back at the time he was shot. You heard it.
Murder! Murder!
I didn't do anything.
Murder!
Why did you shoot me before he died?
Yes.
And even in the face of all of that evidence, forensic evidence, there was no gunpowder on his hands. He did not shoot at or shoot Officer Masso. There's no way he was armed with a weapon that was found 20 to 30 feet away from his body. Forensically, scientifically, that is impossible.
Impossible!
And we know that, they know that.
That's right.
And they clear him of any charges.
Right, shameful.
They clear him of any charges.
Shameful.
As I stand here in front of OPD, this brings back a lot of bad memories from the day May 7th when I came here asking questions about my son and what happened to him. And I have a question. And I want the community to question, how can you stand behind someone chasing down this, that shoots himself? That shoots himself. It should be a shame. That is against the law. You are running with your pistol out and you shoot yourself and turn your weapon on an innocent victim.
That's right.
And take his life. And you can go home to your family. And you can watch your daughter graduate. And you can be there at their wedding. And you can stand here, DA, police chief, mayor of Oakland, and call it justified. That is homicide.
That's right.
That is genocide.
That's right.
And the Justice for Allen Blueford Coalition, which is acronyms of JAB, we got to jab the shit out of you until you do something about it.
Like 902, I know why we speak about them. My grandfather's a girl.
supposed to be a risk. Tell me that's a wire case for something we've never tasted. Some people who call us where our balance is evil. You're putting on the balance of now.
Come on.